You are in a plane. The engine of the plane, the engines, because planes don't carry just one engine, the engines all failed, and the plane is coming to crash. You guys are four in the plane, and then there are three parachutes. That means one person cannot jump off. You grabbed one, the other two persons grabbed one. Just when you are about to jump, God said to you, carry your own parachute, give to the other person that doesn't have. Stay in the plane or jump out without parachute. How many of you will obey? You are a young man here, firstborn in your family. From a poor family, your parents struggled to train you in school, sold land. You finished school in Nigeria. 5 years, no job. Then on the sixth year, when things have gotten out of hand, an opportunity opened up in NMPC. You applied, you wrote the aptitude test, whatever. You passed all of that. Then one more thing, interview. An interview is scheduled to happen in a particular day. Three of you qualified, but they are looking for just two. And it is that interview that we determine. So you are about to go with your other three friends, but it happened that the only vehicle that will take you there, and if you miss that one, you are missing the interview time, and if you come late, even by 5 minutes, you're already disqualified. The only vehicle that could take you there had only two chances. Only two. And you are the first to even get one of the two available spaces and the other person gets. Then, when you're about to sit down, God says, Mark, stand up. Give it to the other person. You go agree? How many of us will give? Ladies, you will relate with this one well. You have been praying for a husband. 30 years, 35, 40, no husband. Then on your 41st birthday, something happened. And one guy came from the U.S. Handsome guy. And at the same time, godly. Ha, this one is prayer answer. Miracle has happened. And he saw you and proposed. This one, you don't even need for him to propose. You'll be the one to propose, self. But he proposed and you said yes. And he has gone to your place to do traditional marriage, pay your dowry. People have done marriage course. You are not prepared for the wedding, and you have set a date for the wedding. Say, on the day of the wedding, on the Saturday, you are in your hotel. They have finished painting you and making you up as a woman, putting all the foundation, screeding, and all of that, you know. You are now wearing your white. Then, as you're stepping out to enter into the car, from your hotel to the parish is just 10 minutes. About 12 minutes for man to start. As you're about to step into the car, God now comes and taps you and say, Chidema, I want you to go and pull this wedding garment. I want you to enter convent. There is a mission in Zamfara. I want you to go and accomplish. How many of you will go? First of all, you will doubt whether it's the voice of God. Especially many of you whom they have been talking to about near success syndrome. They have been teaching you about near success syndrome. Once that voice comes, you even begin to cast and bind. I know this is not the voice of God. Village people are here. I bind you in the name of Jesus Christ. We usually think that it was that easy for Abraham to go and kill his son, his only son. Don't let the complexities, don't let the perplexity, don't let the difficulty that's in true on Abraham be lost on you and myself. Go and kill your son. It wasn't easy for Abraham. And he was the only one who heard it. Do you think that if Abraham had told Sarah that sacrifice would have taken place? Eh? Imagine that Abraham came to Sarah and said, hey, Sarah, God said I should carry Isaac and go and kill. What do you think Sarah would have told Abraham? He would have said, Oga, I've been suspecting you since. You are a ritualist. That is even the reason I have not had birth. So this one I have got now. They say you should bring it and come and kill Abby. He didn't tell no one. There are some things that God tells you, you can't tell anybody. They will sound too bizarre, too crazy. And God does not expect you to tell anybody because nobody will believe you. It's like Mary. I told you before. When Mary got pregnant by the visit of the Holy Spirit, do you think she was the one that told Joseph? She wasn't the one I told you because don't even dare. Joseph will not listen to you. Joseph was the one who discovered. And it was God that told Joseph himself. There are some things, there are some revelations, there are some encounters you have with God as an individual. It's not your business to tell another person because you'll be wasting your time. Praise God.
To watch full videos and get notifications for new ones, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. God bless you.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online. Meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religions. Download the app from Google Play Store.